Thank you. Thank you. flip-flop has an incredibly silly name, there's no doubt about it. But it's probably one of the most useful redstone circuits in Minecraft, and pretty much every single one of my redstone contraptions has one of some form somewhere. What it does is it converts a redstone pulse into a constant redstone output that you can toggle on or off. So today we're going to take a look at every single variation of the T flip-flop, every design that you can possibly use. I've spent the past couple days thinking about this, so hopefully I haven't missed out any obvious ones, but this should give you a very good selection to work from. Design number one is arguably the most common, making use of a sticky piston monostable circuit. Now what this thing does is it converts this redstone pulse from the button into a one tick pulse that we then send through this repeater and into this piston, and what that one tick pulse does is it causes the piston to spit out its block. Now sadly this only works in the Minecraft Java edition, because that is the only version of Minecraft that actually involves this piston spitting mechanic, which is a bit of a shame because it's incredibly useful. I use it pretty much everywhere. Now this right here is a semi-silent version of the flip-flop. When we hit this button, you can hear we get a tick, but we don't get any piston noises going on, and it works by cycling items round inside the droppers. So right now the item is inside this dropper right here, then when we hit the button it gets sent up into this dropper because this dropper is facing upwards, and then when we hit the button again the item gets sent across, it goes into this dropper here, makes its way down into this hopper, which then cycles it back round into that dropper there, and you take the output out the side with a comparator, which then of course runs out to show off this redstone lamp. An alternative way of using this configuration is to run a dropper facing upwards, a dropper facing across, a hopper facing down, and then a dropper running back across into this dropper here. So it kind of goes up and round in a cycle, and that means that you can take the comparator output from directly behind the button. So it's kind of all in line like this, as opposed to coming out the side. It's behind the button. It's a pretty good alternative. This design right here works in a similar fashion to the first one, making sure that we have one tick pulses to cause this sticky piston here to spit out its blocks. But instead of using a monostable circuit, this actually makes use of observers being moved, which means that we've managed to shave off one one block of the total length, and also we've managed to make it a little bit shorter as well. It's only two blocks tall. A design that I distinctly remember working back in the olden days was this system right here.